One way of connecting to our Cisco Catalyst switch over the network is to use Telnet. And Telnet is considered non-secure because data is sent in plain text. If somebody had some sort of a packet capture utility like Wireshark and they captured our Telnet packets, well, the content of those Telnet packets, including our password, would be in clear text. They could read that. And therefore, we tend to prefer SSH, secure shell, as opposed to Telnet, because with SSH, the transmissions are going to be encrypted. But Telnet is still used quite a bit, and we need to be familiar with it. Before we try to connect remotely using Telnet, let's make sure that Telnet is allowed as an input transport on our VTY lines. We can check this out. Remember, we've got 16 VTY lines that we have configured, 0 through 15. Let's do a show line VTY 0 to get an idea of what transports are going to be allowed. And we're coming in to the switch, so we're concerned about input transports instead of output transports. That would apply to sessions initiated from the switch. We're coming into the switch, so we want to check out the input transports. And we've got a couple. Both Telnet and Secure Shell are enabled. If we wanted to change that, we could go in to line configuration mode for VTY 0 through 15. And from here, we can say transport input, and let's give some context-sensitive help by pressing a question mark. Pressing a question mark at this time tells me the commands that are available at this point. And we could say no protocols are going to be coming into the switch, none. All, which would include both Telnet and Secure Shell, that's what we have right now. Or if I just wanted to do one or the other, I could say transport input Telnet, and that would make Secure Shell unsupported. Or I could do transport input SSH, and that would make Telnet unsupported. For now, we'll just leave it at the default of transport input all, but at least that is how we check things out. Well, it looks like Telnet is enabled. We've already done a ping to confirm that we've got connectivity over the network to the switch. So now, let's fire up a terminal emulator and connect into this Cisco Catalyst switch. We could use a variety of terminal emulators. One is PuTTY. One is TerraTerm. Both are freely downloadable from the internet. Right now I'm in TerraTerm. Let's see how we can initiate a connection. Let's go under File and say New Connection. And here's the IP address of my Cisco Catalyst switch. And notice I can select my transport. Is it Secure Shell? Is it Telnet? In this video, we want to do Telnet. And I'll say OK. And look at that. It gives me a password prompt. We've already set up the password prompt previously. I'll just type in Cisco and press Enter. And we're now connected to the switch. Let's go into enable mode, and I'm going to say show line, and we can see that we are connected via a VTY line. There's an asterisk next to that. And while we're here, let's take a look at how we can navigate around this environment just a little bit. If I were to type into commands such as show IP interface brief, and I wanted to possibly edit that line, here's what I could do. As a shortcut, I could enter Control A to jump my cursor to the beginning of the line. I could do a Control E to go to the end of the line. If I wanted to delete the previous word in this command, I could do a Control W. If I wanted to delete the entire current line, I could do a Control X. Let me type this command in again. Let's do a show IP interface brief. And I want to enter a couple of commands, actually. I want to have a command history. Cisco IOS can remember the commands we've typed in. Let's do a show run. And I'll just quit out of that. Let's do one more. Let's do a show memory. I just wanted to have a few commands in history to play with. What we can do is say Control P, and that's going to pull up from history our prior command. Control N is going to move us forward in our history. So think of P for previous and N for next. Control P, previous, Control N, next. Something else that will work on your keyboard, you can use the up and down arrows. I'm pressing the up arrow now to scroll through my history buffer, and now I'm pressing the down arrow to scroll back down. If we want to see everything in the history buffer, we can say show history, by the way. And by default, we have our 20 previous commands stored in our history buffer. If we want to change that, we can go into line VTY 015 configuration mode and say history size, and we can have as many as 256 lines of history stored. I'm going to bump it up to, let's say, 100 lines of history that are going to be stored. And let me give you just a couple of other shortcut commands. What if we did my show IP interface brief command again, and let's move the cursor back to the I in interface. Check out what happens when I do a control K. A control K deletes from the cursor position through the rest of the line. Let me type the command back in, show IP interface brief, and let's move my cursor back to the I. I could do a control U or a control X. They do the same thing. Either of those commands would delete all of the characters to the left of the cursor. Let's just do a control X and it deletes everything to the left of the cursor. And I've put those commands up on screen for you right now as a reference. You might want to jot these down in your notes. This can come in really handy in the real world as you're navigating around Cisco iOS. And at this point, we've connected using TerraTerm, but another common terminal emulator is PuTTY. Let's take a quick look at PuTTY. Let's get PuTTY launched. And I'm saying Telnet as my connection type. Here's the IP address of my switch. Let's say open, and let's get logged in. If I do a show line, we see that I'm now connected to a couple of VTY lines. This is my connection via PuTTY. This is my connection via TerraTerm. This is my connection via the console. Again, TerraTerm and PuTTY, a couple of freely available terminal emulators out on the internet. Or you might be using something like Mac OS X. Let's bring up a Mac OS X terminal window. And from here, we could simply say Telnet 192.168.1.11. And let's enter the password. And I'm connected using the terminal that's built into Mac OS X. And again, in summary, Telnet is commonly used for a remote connection into our device. However, Cisco recommends that we use Secure Shell, SSH, because Secure Shell is going to encrypt the data that we're transmitting and receiving to and from the device, as opposed to Telnet, which sends and receives in clear text.